We don't see President Biden. We don't see Vice President Harris coming down, because if they did, they would have to do the exact same thing. They would have to fix the problem, and they don't have the political will to do it.
All right, Brandon Judd there, the president of the National Border Patrol Council, slamming the Biden administration for their tremendous failures at today's Border Security Caucus briefing in El Paso, Texas. Last week, we showed you this video that was obtained by a local Tennessee TV station. This is showing migrant children landing at the Chattanooga airport at night before being bussed into various other U.S. cities. A pretty sneaky move from the Biden administration. Children snuck into towns and cities without knowledge or permission from any of the communities involved. And all of this, as you see, happening in the dead of night. It really is something else. For more on this, we're going to bring in Tennessee Senator Marsha Blackburn. Senator, thank you so much for joining us.
Good to be with you. But I have to tell you, people in Tennessee are really upset about what is going on, especially because the governor had declined the request from HHS to house migrant children. And we know that this is basically a violation of Tennessee's 10th Amendment rights. We also know that what the Biden administration is trying to do, since they have now apprehended more than 500,000 migrants, since Joe Biden took office, that what they're trying to do is shift the burden, all the cost, over to the states and the counties where they are going to have these children. They have to be housed. They have to have children's services. Sure. They have to have education. They have to have health care. And communities are not set up for this. These are traumatized children who have been under these cartels making this very strenuous journey. They have thought that they were walking into something that was going to be complete freedom. And then you have the situation that has arisen. And it is why the Remain in Mexico policy that President Trump had in place needs to go back into effect.
Yeah, and sadly, I think it never will. I don't think they would ever be able to implement that.
Well, trying to get it. Yeah. I've got the legislation, and we're working on that.
You're trying. Yes. Yeah, you're putting up the good fight. I'll give you that. In a recent letter to the Biden administration, you, along with Senator Bill Hagerty and Congressman Chuck Fleischmann, wrote, "The basic question that must be answered is whether the federal government is using Tennessee as a central location for resettling unaccompanied alien children in the United States." I suspect you never got an answer from the Biden administration.
Did not get an answer at all. But see, what Biden is doing is turning every town into a border town and every state into a border state by going through this process of basically sneaking into a state, if you will, during the middle of the night, putting these children on buses. When people wake up the next morning, these children are in their community in shelters. They are there. And as I said, there are many needs that come with these migrant children.
Yeah. It's been 2 months since Kamala Harris was appointed the border czar. She hasn't done much, as we know. Today, she was at a virtual meeting on high-speed internet. Here's the press secretary talking about that.
Well, the vice president is overseeing exactly the same portfolio that the president did when he was vice president, which is the Northern Triangle, an engagement with countries in the region about how we can work together to reduce the rate of migration. I expect she will make a trip to the Northern Triangle at some point soon.
You know, it's almost like a diplomatic approach to a problem that's really not that vexing of an issue. You know, well, we're talking to people in the Northern Triangle about, you know, this is a show up kind of moment, and they're not showing up.
Well, you're exactly right about that. It is a show-up moment. And no, they are AWOL, if you will, when it comes to immigration and border issues. This is Joe Biden's immigration policy. This is his policy. And it is his policy that broke the system. President Trump had things in order. He had the Remain in Mexico policy. He was giving the Border Patrol the three things that they have said for decades they need. They need a border wall. They need better surveillance. They need more boots on the ground to help secure that border.
And it's
he gave them what they
It's really not. I mean, he gave them what they needed, and it was very common sense. It doesn't have to be political. It doesn't have to be a race thing. It's just you need to have a secure border. We're a country like every other country in the world. It doesn't just have an open border. I don't get why that's so sensitive and so irresponsible to think on the left that that could be the way it should be. Tennessee Senator Marsha Blackburn, thank you so much for the time. Good to see you, as always.
Good to see you. Thank you.
All right.